You look at the money they've spent this offseason, the years that they've committed to some of these players, the 2 years, the 3 years, that sort of thing, Jack. And I go back to what you said. The analytics department puts a dollar value on certain players, and they're just not going to go wildly over that, which I would guess is why they've signed a lot of these players who they like are quality players, but they don't want to go to that number of 30 million plus for Manny Machado.
Right. They have not shown any indication or any inclination to do that, Bob. And yesterday there was a lot of noise on social media because a couple of respected reporters reported that the White Sox had the best offer out there for Machado at 7 for $175 million. That caused Dan Lozano, Machado's agent, to come out and say that is wrong, that's inaccurate, and he took shots at it. But here's the thing. Whether the 175 was accurate or not, I don't think anybody believes he's going to sign for that amount. It's going to be into the twos. He's going to get some kind of deal like that. That didn't change anything within the Yankee world. Reached out to some people around the Yankees and people who deal with the Yankees today, and they said that that hasn't changed their viewpoint. They've marched forward with what they want to do for this offseason. And you asked me last show, Bob, are they totally out? And I said 90%, and I'm going to stick to that 90%. All it takes is one phone call for something to change, but the vibe I'm getting from people around the organization is that they are happy and content with the moves that they have made, and that Manny Machado does not seem to be one of the players that they're going to pursue.